there are a lot of bad apples out there.
Get it?
But this video doesn't feature any of those because these are the best Mac apps 2022 edition. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. For the last few years, I've been making a short list of free macOS app recommendations. And wouldn't you know, it's that time of the year again already. So these are the best macOS apps every user needs. Come on, let's go. As usual, be sure to stick around to the end of the list for a bonus macOS app recommendation. And if you're wondering why some of your favorite free macOS apps haven't made the list this year, it's quite possible I've covered them before, because I've been making macOS app recommendation videos since 2018, so that's like 4 or 5 years of these videos. I can do math. And I try not to be repetitive every year, so I have links to all of those videos in the description below. So first up is CopyClip, a clipboard manager for your Mac. And yes, just like with all of these apps on today's list, it's completely free. So the CopyClip app is tucked away nicely up in your menu bar, and it stores everything you've copied or cut. But what I find most handy about CopyClip is that you can easily search to find the text you're looking for. So if you copied something earlier in the day, but have since copied other text, no worries, you don't have to open the document to recopy that text. You can just copy it by clicking on it right in CopyClip and then pasting it wherever you need. Plus, you can set your preferences too with CopyClip, so you can decide how many clippings you want it to save and how many you want it to display at one time. Did I mention how handy this is? I love it. Okay, now on to some handy task managers. Second on my list of best free Mac apps is Notion. I feel like everybody's using Notion or everybody's talking about Notion. So if you need a really good project management tool or note-taking app, Notion could be for you. Notion is a robust management app, that is for sure. So you can take organized notes and make to-do lists. You can create subpages and embed links as well. Plus, it's a really good tool if you work with a team, since you can keep track of what you're working on by creating something called views. Now, these so-called views let you add in notes or projects, and you just click on it to expand that view. And of course, you can change the status of views to reflect your progress. Now, there are a few paid tiers to Notion, so if you want a lot of these team features, that part is in a paid version, but they have a free personal version, which is great if you're just getting started and you want to personally stay on track. If Notion isn't quite right for you, then you'll want to check out number 3 on my list of best Mac apps 2022, TickTick. That's right, this is a powerful yet easy to use task manager. I love it. So TickTick works across platforms, so you can easily move and stay organized from mobile to web. But my favorite part about TickTick, besides the awesome name, of course, is the ability to add tasks quickly via keyboard shortcuts. So, for example, you can use Command plus Shift plus A from any screen you're on to quickly add a task, and then you would just hit Tab to add a description to that task. Now, you can also share your tasks with others in TickTick, and of course, you can manage your tasks right from the menu bar as well. And wouldn't you know, there's another shortcut to access the menu bar. You just hit Command plus Shift plus O to show or hide that menu bar app. And before we continue on to number 4 on my list, if you are liking this video so far, please remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for even more content like this. I'd be so appreciative. And now, back to the list. Next on my list of free macOS app recommendations is Google News. Okay, so this is a web app and it's not one you actually download to your Mac, but it still counts. So all you have to do is head on over to google.com/news, or you could type news.google.com, either way, and you're gonna get an idea of everything that's going on in the world around you. You'll have top stories, news curated just for you based on your interests. You're going to have your local country news, your local city news, business and entertainment, sports, science, health news, everything you can think of, tech news, everything all in one spot. I tend to head here about once a day and get a good snapshot of what's going on in the world and what's going on around me. Plus, of course, there are Android and iOS apps that you can get your news on too. All right, now that you have a handle on your tasks and news, it might be time for a little break. Well, not a break from this video, a break from your workday, obviously. With that said, fifth on my list of free macOS app recommendations is timeout break reminders. Think of timeout as a forced break throughout your workday. So if you're like me and you end up staring at your screen for hours on end, your eyes will definitely thank you if you take a few breaks. So timeout is really simple. It forces you to take a break by dimming your screen so you can't actually use it for a specified amount of time. Now don't worry, you're gonna set the frequency and length of the breaks. So timeout comes with suggested breaks for you, but you can take micro breaks every 15 or 20 minutes and set the duration to last just a few seconds so you can allow your eyes to refocus on something else other than a screen. Or you can set normal breaks throughout your workday where you can get up and stretch and move your body or have lunch away from your desk or retrain your eyes or whatever it is that you desire that's not you staring at your screen. So initially I thought this would be a little annoying, especially while editing all day, but I do have to say that typically by the end of a workday, my eyes are so dry and I just wanna scratch them out of my head and I have to take my contacts out right away. So this is a really easy way for me to take more mindful eye breaks throughout the day. And last but not least, well before our bonus app, number six is one of my absolute favorite apps that's on my MacBook Pro right now, and it's called Meter. And for some reason, I always want to say meter, but anyway, I really don't know why, that's just me. It allows you to keep track of and join any and all of your meetings faster in one place. So check this out. If you've got different meeting apps on the go, like Google Meet and Zoom and WebEx and Teams or whatever the heck everyone else is using, you can connect your calendar to Meter and it will automatically pull all of your upcoming calls from different platforms so they are stored in one central spot. Hallelujah. So not only will all of your calls be neatly organized in Meter, but you can join the call right from there too. So you no longer have to switch from calendar to calendar and find and click on links. With Meter, they're all in one spot. Plus, if you have an upcoming meeting, it's going to appear directly in your menu bar, and you're going to have a little countdown to the next meeting in your calendar in that menu bar, so you'll know how long it is until your next meeting. How neat is that? And you set your preferences in Meter to choose whether a browser link should be opened or if the native app should be used on launch, like with Zoom, for example. Meter is, of course, totally free. And get this, they're extending their Pro for free to users just for a limited time. So run, don't walk on this one. And true to form, let's throw in a bonus Mac app here for you. Complete Anatomy. Yeah, okay, I've gone off the rails. It is completely random, but just follow along on this. It's a good one. So remember when we were growing up and we'd look through medical books at the complete anatomy and human body? No? Just me? Oh, well, this is awkward. But anyway, if you're a nerd like me and you want to learn even more about the human anatomy, then this Mac app is for you. It's so cool. Complete Anatomy offers interactive 3D modeling of the entire skeletal and connective tissue layers. So, you can zoom in for more details and also to animate the muscle movements. And it sounds weird, but I always forget the name of like certain muscle groups. And this is just a quick educational reference for me. This app is also a great way to teach kids about the human body for free. no library card needed, and no need to actually leave the house to do so. Gotta love it. Phew, we made it. Now again, I am linking to all my Mac app recommendations from 2018 through 2021 in the description below, and I'm gonna have them again at the end of this video. So those are my 2022 free macOS app recommendations. And now I wanna hear from you. What are your absolute favorite free Mac apps? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here and here for more Mac app videos. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.